I'm here to tell you that loneliness is just a state of mind, and it's not your reality. Loneliness is a big city epidemic, and a lot of people come across feeling disconnected from others, whether it's friends, family, intimate partners. The thing with loneliness is that it's not our reality, it's our perception of reality. I remember my grandfather complaining to me and my brother. He used to tell us, "Why won't you come and visit me often?" And that guy was very successful during his heydays. He was a football player. Later on, he became a scientist. He patented several scientific findings. He was well respected amongst his peers. He was in his late 60s. We were staying at home all the time. When he told us about not visiting him so often, he mentioned that loneliness is the most horrible thing that you can experience as a person. Of course, I was a child and couldn't understand the complexity of what he was trying to convey. Now that I'm much more older and wiser, I hope, I understand that this state of mind either makes you or breaks you. Let me clarify that makes you part. Yes, of course, you feel disconnected, you feel alone, you feel unsatisfied with your life. But as everything else in your life, when you feel some dissatisfaction, it's a good sign. It's a good sign that you have to make some changes in your life, because loneliness won't go away. It's a state of mind that signals to you that your life situation doesn't work for you for now. There's a big misconception about loneliness. People always think that they have to be accepted for who they are. But the thing is, we people are very social creatures, which also means that we don't do stuff unconditionally for each other. That's what made us great survivalists on this planet. And this character of ours has been developing in hundreds and hundreds and thousands of years. If you just think about it, we people, we're not good at anything. We're not good at running compared to other animals. We're not good at swimming compared to other animals. We cannot fly, we don't have big teeth, but what we have is a big brain. Big brain that made us a very fatal foe. The characteristic that contributed in our development most was our ability to communicate. Our communication skills made us very good organizers in hunting, gathering, protecting ourselves, and even sheltering. What I'm trying to say is that our communication is a two-way street. If I help you with something, you have to help me back. And this crucial notion has been neglected by many of us in our private lives. Going back to the topic at hand, loneliness is a consequence of us not feeling fulfilled. Because on one hand, we think that we deserve the best in the world, that we should be loved by who we are. But on the other hand, we feel like we don't have to do anything in order to get this kind of treatment. To conclude this story about human evolution, if I feel lonely, that means I'm not contributing to other people. I'm not making other people feel good about themselves. Loneliness comes from us not creating value for others. We feel entitled, we feel greedy. Our needs have to be fulfilled without us doing anything in exchange. So loneliness is not about lacking something. It's not about being dumb and stupid or socially awkward. It's about not putting the work. People have different life situations. You can be a teenager feeling lonely and not accepted and maybe bullied. Or you can be a middle-aged IT worker working 9-to-5 and feeling that your day-to-day life is some kind of limbo. Whether you're a person from the first example or the second example, you can always overcome this state of mind. And you do that by practicing. You do that by becoming the better version of yourself. You do that by treating yourself with utmost love. The life is about growth. The life is about developing. As soon as you stagnate, you're going to feel miserable. So what can you do in order to overcome loneliness? You can look at yourself in the mirror and break down your personality bit by bit. Tell yourself what you have to do in order to be the better version of yourself. Compete with yourself. Be a better person than you were 1 year ago, half a year ago, 1 month, 1 week. If you lack social skills, there are many YouTube channels that give great advice. Also get some books that will give you knowledge on social interactions. If you're overweight, hit the gym. Make your body better. Make yourself feel better about yourself. It's not about others and what they think about you. It's about yourself and you being comfortable in your own skin. And I'm telling you, the second you feel that you have become much more comfortable in your own skin, more people are going to notice you. You're going to attract more people to your life as soon as you feel that void of insecurity. Insecurity is a consequence of you not feeling comfortable in one or another area in your life. As soon as you get better in those areas, whether it's physical aspects, social skills, maybe getting better results at your work or at your school, you're going to feel much better with yourself. And that per se is going to attract other people in your life. Because you're going to emanate aura of security, confidence, and happiness. I hope it made some sense and you got some perspective on loneliness. If you have some questions, ask them down below and I will get back to you.